am Dr. Jayatirtha Joshi, working as a consultant pediatric surgeon. PUJ obstruction, when you see the urinary system, urine produced in the kidney and they will be connected with the urinary bladder where the urine is stored by the pipe called as ureter. So there is obstruction at the level of kidneys in this pipe, it is called as PUJ obstruction. So how to identify this condition? So it depends on the age at which it's identified. Most commonly nowadays with antenatal scanning, means when the fetus is in the uterus, that time they do a regular antenatal scan, that time also it can be diagnosed. Or they may present with the non-specific symptoms like pain abdomen, pain in the tummy, or they may present with the urinary tract infections. So how to diagnose it? Diagnosis usually by the initially when we evaluate for pain abdomen or anything which is diagnosed antenatally, we do the ultrasound, then we find there is a swelling in the kidney. So it means that there is some obstruction in the upper urinary tract. So to confirm how much obstruction is there, we do, it's called as a nuclear scan, which it will assess the function of the kidney, involved kidney, and also how much severe is the obstruction is. So after assessing these by these two tests, we can do the surgery. It can be done either open surgery, that means open surgery means we make an incision or the we open the body and then do the surgery, or it's also called as keyhole or minimally invasive, or also it's called as laparoscopic surgery. So principle of treatment is that we have to take out the whatever the causing obstruction and rejoin the those cut parts. So then we again assess at the age of after the surgery, maybe after 6 months, again with the nuclear scans, and to clear that there is a obstruction is resolved. So this is one of the preventable cause of kidney failure in children. So if you treat at appropriate time, then we can avoid the complications like stone formation, or there may be a pus formation in the kidney, or sometimes the kidney may go fail without the notice. So next common condition which I am going to discuss is about, is called as vesico-ureteric reflux. So first you should understand what is vesico-ureteric reflux. Vesico-ureteric reflux means when the kidney produces urine, so it comes to the urinary bladder through a pipe called ureter. Someone voids, means micturates, so it should empty completely so that there is no residual urine. In the condition called as vesico-ureteric reflux, the when the someone passes urine, so around 60 to 70% of the urine comes out, and around maybe around 20 to 30% it refluxes back into the kidney, causing the problem. So as I discussed earlier, it can be diagnosed antenatally, but we cannot see antenatally how the urine goes back into the kidney, but we can predict. So if there is a kidney swelling in the antenatal scans, but mainly they present with urinary tract infection, repeated urinary tract infections, failure to thrive, or sometimes they may present at the later stage as the kidney failure. So when you find the children with a history of urinary tract infection or any other symptoms, with the fever, then they are not feeding well, or there is no growth, or it's called as growth retardation. When we do first in preliminary test, that's urine routine, where you send maybe whenever there is infection, you see pus cells in the urine, and then you go do the urine culture to identify the organism. Then we have to treat appropriately with the antibiotics. Then how to confirm whether there is a vesico-ureteric reflux? There are different methods are there how to identify them. So most commonly we use called as micturating cystourethrogram. This is a test where you are putting the catheter into the bladder, and we put a radio opaque dye or a medicine which will be seen in the X-ray. When child voids, we will take the films and will come to know that the complete urine is coming out, or there is a reflux of the urine back into the kidneys. So when this type of reflux is there, we again grade it depending upon the how much severe it is. So followed by we do again a nuclear scan, which will identify if there any scars are there in the kidneys. So if you identify in the say immediate neonatal period or less than 1 year, usually we keep them on it's called as continuous antibiotic prophylaxis. Continuous antibiotic prophylaxis means we give small dose of antibiotic every day at the night to prevent the infection. Sometimes they resolve on their own if the reflux is lower grade, means that there is a severity is lesser one. So we can manage like that. Maybe at the age of 5 years they resolve. But if the children having repeated infections, growth retardation, and the when we do DMSA renal scans, it shows a scar, then we have to do the surgery. Surgery means we have to do a surgery in such a way that when a child voids, it should not reflux back. So it can be done either open surgery or also called as minimal invasive surgery or laparoscopic surgery. By doing this, we can prevent the urine reflux and we can stop the renal or kidney damage, then so that child improves and we can prevent the kidney failure in the children. And this is one of the leading cause of surgical cause of renal failure in all over the world.